Freddie came up with a magnificent little sort of foray into white gospel, if you want to call it that. And we really worked our harmonies on Somebody to Love.
Freddie's great inspiration for Somebody to Love was Aretha Franklin. He absolutely loved Aretha. Freddie would like to have been Aretha Franklin, I suppose. Somebody, 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 somebody. From that point of view, okay, Bohemian Rhapsody, big hit, but I think a song like Somebody to Love is, in my estimation, a better sort of, from the writing aspect, a better song.
The Day at the Races was the first album the band had produced themselves, and despite EMI receiving the highest advance orders ever for an LP, on its release, still the critics were less than favourable. However, that didn't stop it from becoming the band's second number one album in the UK and going on to become one of their most successful to date, proving nobody gives a shit what the critics think. In addition to Somebody to Love, the album was home to Queen classics such as You Take My Breath Away, Millionaire Waltz and Good Old Fashioned Lover Boy, deep cut favourites such as Drowse and Long Away, as well as the ultimate live stalwart, Tie Your Mother Down. Japanese fans, the album also delivered a song they cherish today as much as they did on its release, as Brian experiences firsthand whenever Queen returned to Japan.
And the old boys used to say, do you want to sing with me? Then we shall do this. This is especially for you. This was written for you guys in Japan a very long time ago. And if you want to sing,
and now we invite you to rock out to a phenomenal live performance of Queen's fifth sensational album, A Day at the Races. Yeah.